Dear students, let us learn about sustainable cities. It is another approach. Now, sustainable, what is sustainability? United States Environmental Protection Agency had said that ideology of maintaining favorable conditions under which humans and nature can coexist in productive harmony to support present and future generations. The World Commission on Environment and Development, that in 1987, coined this term of sustainable development. And in their book, Our Common Future, it is stated that development that meets the needs of the present generation without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. So it contains within two concepts, the concept of needs, in particular, the essential needs of the world's poor, to which overriding priority should be given, and the idea of limitations imposed by the state of technology and social organization on the environment's ability to meet the present and future needs. Now, sustainability has three components or three spheres which are interrelated. One is about economic sustainability, that is, economic activity should be self-renewing, able to build local assets, and it should be self-reliant. Then comes social sustainability. Social sustainability relates to the opportunity for full participation of people in all activities or of stakeholders in all activities and decision making of a society. And when this overlaps, as I said, they are interrelated. So when social progress is coupled with economic development, it generates a fair world. Now we come to the third component of sustainability, that is environmental sustainability, which talks about communities are responsible for protecting and building natural assets. And because many a times economics and environment don't see eye to eye and there are conflicts. But when they come together in a harmonious way, the economic development and environmental responsibility leads to a viable world. And the social progress and environmental responsibility, if people are aware of their environmental responsibility, not only about their rights, but also about their responsibilities, then it results in a livable world. Now, what is an Oxford definition? Now, Oxford Dictionary definition says, city constructed to minimize environmental degradation with facilities such as transport, waste management, etc., which are designed so as to limit their impact on the natural environment while providing the infrastructure needed for its inhabitants, is basically termed as sustainable city. Siemens in 2013 said that the aim is to create smallest possible ecological footprint, produce low or no pollution, to efficiently use land, to recycle and convert waste to energy, and make the city's overall contribution to climate change minimal. There have been various international initiatives. The World Commission, United Nations World Commission on Environment and Development, had coined the term. But there have been, after that, post the conference, there have been various international initiatives. And one of them is the Sustainable Development Goals. So UNDP has developed this goals in 2015 for a 15-year period, that is till 2030. And if you see, the 11th goal is to develop sustainable cities and communities. Now, Coming to the sustainability index, how do we say that a city is sustainable or not sustainable? So the index talks about the people, the planet, and the profit. So in the people, we find that the education, health, demographics, income inequality, affordability, work-life balance, and crime are related to people, and they are the indicators related to people. Now, what are the indicators related to profit or business or economy? So they are transport infrastructure, economic development, ease of doing business, tourism, connectivity, and employment. And about the planet, sustainability indicators or the index talks about environmental risks, about green spaces, energy, air pollution, greenhouse gas emission, waste management, and drinking water and sanitation. The good case studies or the cities which qualify to be a sustainable city, the forerunner for this is Curitiba in Brazil, it's in southern Brazil, and it had a population of 2 million and area of 15,000 square kilometers. What were the challenges of the city? It was transport congestion, lack of open greens and basic services, mass unemployment, uncontrolled growth of squatter settlements. And the strategies which were put forth to overcome the challenges were physical integration of a public transport system, land use regulation, and hierarchy of road network. Modest express route system with dedicated bus lanes, reduced traffic resulting in reduced carbon emissions. About 60 square meters of green area per inhabitant, one of the highest rates among all cities in the world, were proposed. They also had interconnected parks, one of which was designed to absorb the flood water, and along with the developed artificial lakes, saving the concrete embankment cost. You can see from this drawing the serviced areas and ratio of park area within a span of a decade. Their second focus area was improved waste management. And 2/3 of the waste which was generated was recycled. And recycle generated jobs, reduced landfill, and was cheaper than landfill as it generated money. Government introduced an equation of co-responsibility involving the green exchange program, enabling slum dwellers to get paid in terms of their fruits and vegetables for the waste they collect by weight. The next city we go to is Mexico City. Mexico is in North America, about 22 million population and about 1500 square kilometer area. So the challenges were pollution, water supply, and urban sprawl. What were the strategies for reducing pollution? Air pollution strategies included reduced carbon emission through introduction of green roof systems along with vertical greens, ECO-BICI, a bicycle sharing program, was introduced in February 2010. BRTS using clean burning ultra low sulfur diesel fuel and metro rail. Regarding garbage disposal, they encouraged waste separation and promoted recycling and composting. They introduced an exchange program, the barter market, where locals could collect inorganic waste, gain green points, and encash them for fresh food. Regarding rejuvenating the Magdalena River for water supply was through participatory planning process, ecological restoration of the upper basin, installation of 9 miles of collectors on the river banks to capture drainage, renovation of 9 public plazas along the margins of the river. The urban sprawl of Mexico was combated or was planned to be combated by making infill and redevelopment cheaper, making land assembly easier, and by creating urban growth boundaries and green belts, making urban expansion difficult, as you can see from this drawing. We come to the last case study, that is Masdar, city in UAE, United Arab Emirates. So Masdar is located 17 kilometers east-southeast of the city of Abu Dhabi, near Abu Dhabi International Airport, with a population of 55,000 and an area of 6 square kilometers. It is a greenfield city, a nude city. Now the challenges were to maintain comfortable temperature in the middle of the desert, energy management and availability of drinking water. Now the strategies which they used to maintain comfortable temperature in the middle of the desert was compact planning, optimal orientation, narrow streets, natural shading, high density, that is about 140 pph, mixed use and walkability. All this was as part of the environmental approach that was adopted as traditional Arabic city design. In regarding energy management, their strategies tried to reduce energy consumption by use of energy efficient techniques, that is insulation, low energy lighting specifications, percentage of glazing, that is in windows, optimizing natural light, installation of smart appliances and smart building management system. Energy generation was planned by using appropriate techniques, that is solar panels and beam down project. Water resources were managed by minimizing the use of local water resources, water conservation at the user end, no tap faucet are triggered by motion sensors and helped in. They also minimize the need for desalinization or desalination as a source of water. Wastewater management strategies were also used, and recycling of about 80% of wastewater was proposed. Regarding solid waste management, waste minimization to landfill was the strategy, and they maximized the resource potential of the materials. Then there was provision of waste chutes in buildings to allow for the separation of wastes. Bio waste was converted to compost and was proposed to be used for landscaping, and recyclable waste was also processed. Regarding mobility, Masdar was also planned as a pedestrian focused community with personal rapid transit, and the PRT ran on guided railways, was proposed to run on guided railways like traditional mass transit. The goal was to achieve a clean, highly efficient transit system with no sacrifice of individual freedom of travel.